fall here right now, one of the best ways to fish is top water. Right now I'm basically at a dead end on the street, and I'm going to show you guys how to walk the dog. This is your basic Zara Spook, looks like a mullet, and I'm going to cast it out there and see, maybe there's a striped bass lurking around or something. Who knows? Let's give it a shot. So what you want to do is you want to get a good cast straight out. I like to stop it before it lands so it's good, and you're going to work the lure back and forth, and that's called walking the dog. And basically, the lure is going back and forth in the water, like on a left to right pattern. There's many ways to do it, but I just do it this way. You can actually hear it going back and forth in the water. If you look, you can zoom in on the lure, you can see it going back and forth. See it coming in? See how it's going back and forth? That's called walking the dog. Bass just love it, bluefish, everything loves it. But that's the right way. You want to be walking the lure. And that's why. If you just go straight like this, that's not good. It's got to go back and forth. Like that. So it's basically a flick of the wrist. Quick little flick of the wrist, and you'll get it. Let's try it again, see what happens. Again, I just cast it into that sunset. You see it going back and forth. Other ways, like if people use a darter, not a darter, I'm sorry, pencil popper, they'll hold it like this and shake the rod like this. But with this, with the Zara Spook, it's a little bit harder to do. See how you're getting the effect on the water? I like to do just pop it back and forth. And what this looks like, an injured mullet right now. Always make sure your hooks aren't, you know, snagged together or anything like that. Stop up or anything. You hear it, how it's going back and forth? You hear it pushing the water all over the place. And when you get a hit on here, it's explosive. Pilot. It's a little hard on me to do it this way because I'm not a lefty.